Okay, today we're going to talk about the fundamental theorem of calculus and the definite integral. So, for chapter S13F. So, we've talked about the definite integral before, but now we're going to be using antiderivatives to help us solve this, and we won't even need a calculator. So, first of all, what is an antiderivative? So, we're going to be doing the derivative backwards. So, for example, if I've got, I'm going to make up an example before we do this. So let's pretend I got f of x equals x to the fifth power. You know that the derivative of this, the 5 gets multiplied to the front coefficient, and then we add this power decreases by 1. This should be straightforward for this. Now, if I want to find the antiderivative, we use a capital F, and we'll be using capital F from now on for antiderivatives. Now, instead of the power decreasing by 1, my power is going to increase by 1. Now, I have to have some sort of coefficient, because when I take the derivative of this, the 5 gets multiplied and becomes the coefficient here. Well, what do I have to have here in order for there to be a coefficient of 1? Well, I'm going to have the reciprocal of this 1/6, because if I take the 6 and multiply it by 1/6, the coefficient that I'm going to have here is 1. You might want to pause and rewind that to think about it. But you can always double check. If I take the derivative of this, the 6 gets multiplied by the 1/6, we left with 1, power decreases by 1. Okay. So, if my function is 3x, the derivative of that is 3. Okay, if my function is this, the derivative of this is going to give me x. If my function is this, the derivative is going to give me this. So, can I take the antiderivative of this? So if f of x equals 3x squared, then the antiderivative, capital F, the antiderivative is going to be the power increases by 1, and then we have 1/3 times this. So 1/3 times that is going to give me 1. So I've got x cubed. This, if I would take the derivative of x cubed, it would become the 3 would be the coefficient, and then my power decreases by 1. So you may want to think about this or replay it if you need help thinking about how to make the antiderivative. Okay, so what is an antiderivative function? So the important thing to know is the antiderivative is the opposite of the derivative. And we're going to be using antiderivatives with a definite integral in order to find the area under a curve. Okay, so here they say, take the derivative of x squared. So if I take the derivative of x squared, the 2 comes to the front, and we end up with 2x. Okay, now if I know the derivative of x squared is 2x, then if I say find the antiderivative of 2x, we just go in reverse from here and we end up getting x squared. And you can always check, because you could do backwards the if the 2 comes to the front. So the reverse of derivatives is the antiderivative. So if my function is 2x and I want to take the antiderivative, the power increases by 1, and the 2 gets, we end up with 1/2 times this value. Okay, so use the fundamental theorem of calculus to find the area of this. So we're going to set the integral from 1 to 3, and my function is 2x, so I'm going to write 2x right here. You can see what I'm doing. And so if I take the antiderivative of this, I'm going to be using the blue function here, x squared. So I'm going to plug in 3 into x squared. I'm going to be plugging 1 into x squared. And then I'm going to have 3 squared minus 1 squared, which is going to give me 9 minus 1, which is 8. Now we can check this with graphical methods with my trapezoid. I know this length of this base is 2. This length of this base is 6. We add them together, we get 8. 1 half of 8 times 2 is going to give me 8. Okay. We can also do this using our calculator. So my function is 2x, right? 2x. And if I graph that, it looks like this. And we're going to take the antiderivative from 1 to 3. So if I press second and trace, and then I'm going to calculate the antiderivative, 7 here, I hit enter. And my lower bound is, what did we say? We're starting at 1, so I hit 1, enter. And my upper bound, we're going to 3, and I hit enter. And now it tells me the area of this is equal to 8. So there's 3 ways to figure out the area under this line. Okay. So, take the derivative of this. So the derivative of this, I'm going to use the lowercase f, because capital case is the antiderivative. So the derivative of this is equal to 3x squared. So hence, find the antiderivative of 3x squared, and the antiderivative of 3x squared is the power increases by 1, it becomes 3, and then we have the reciprocal of this, 1/3 times that, it's just going to give me this. Okay? So, use the fundamental theorem of calculus to find the area of this. So, fundamental theorem of calculus says we're going to start with 0 and go to 1. My function is 3x squared. And then you have to always end your integration with dx. Okay. Now, we know the antiderivative is this guy right here. This is my antiderivative. So, using this relationship, this is going to be equal to the antiderivative with a value of 1, because that's our upper bound, minus the antiderivative with a value of 0. Okay, we just said the antiderivative is x cubed, so I'm going to plug in 1 in place of x for x cubed. I end up with 1 cubed minus, and now I'm going to plug in 0 in place of x for x cubed. And then I end up with 1 cubed minus 0 cubed, and I'm going to end up with an area of 1. Okay, let's check this using our calculator. Okay, clear. Okay, my function is 3x squared, right? Okay, second trace, we're going to do the integral. I hit enter. Okay, there's my function. My lower bound is 0, enter. My upper bound is 1, I hit type in 1, and enter. And now it tells me the area under this part of the curve is 1, which is what we got here. Okay, you should always use your calculator to check your work. Okay, the next one. Okay, take the derivative of 1/4 x to the 4th. Okay, so if I'm taking the derivative, I'm going to use the lowercase f. And if I'm taking the derivative of this, the power decreases by 1, and we end up with x to the 3rd, and then the 4 gets multiplied by the 1/4, and then that just becomes x cubed. Okay, therefore, hence, find the antiderivative of x cubed. So if I'm trying to find the antiderivative of x cubed, then the antiderivative of x cubed is going to be the power increases by 1, so I end up with x to the 4th. And then I have to have the reciprocal of this value, so the reciprocal of 1/4 of 4 is 1/4. And you can always double check, is the derivative of this equal to this? Power gets multiplied by the front, 4 times 1/4, it's going to go away. This power decreases by 1, we end up with x cubed. So the antiderivative of x cubed is 1/4 x to the 4th power. Okay. Use the fundamental theorem of calculus to find the area of this from 0 to 1. So let's write this out. 0 to 2 x cubed dx. So one of the ways to write this down, one of the notations, is I can write it like this, where I draw a tall line here, and we know the bound here is 0, and the upper bound is 2. And the antiderivative of this, we already said, is 1/4 x to the 4th. You're going to see that this is going to be written this way on a later page. So here's my antiderivative, is 1/4 x to the 4th. And now I'm going to plug in 2, and I'm going to plug in 0. So we're going to plug in 2 first, because it's the upper bound. So because we're supposed to be f of 2 minus antiderivative f of 0. So if I plug in 2 in first, we end up with 1/4 times 2 to the 4th power minus 1/4 times 0 to the 4th power. And then that's going to simplify. Okay, that's going to go away, right? 2 to the 4th power is 16, and 16 divided by 4 is going to give me 4. Okay. And let me show the answers for the next two. You may want to hit pause to think about this. So we said the antiderivative of this was 1/4. So I'm going to plug in 3 in place of x. And then I'm going to plug in 2 in place of x and subtract the 2. Okay. Now, comment on your answer for part B. So notice, this is the definite integral. This is the area under the curve between 0 and 2. This is the area under the curve between 2 and 3. Notice, if I add these two together, the 4 plus the 16, okay, and then I do the integral between 0 and 3, and we get 20.25. This goes from 0 to 2, this goes from 2 to 3. If I wanted to do the integral from just plain old 0 to 3, you're going to find out that these two are going to add up to this one here. If I go integral from 0 to 2 of this, and from 2 to 3 of this, it's going to be the same thing as if I simply went from 0 to 3. Okay, let's do the next part. Okay. Okay, so find the antiderivative of 4 plus 2x. So the antiderivative is going to be 4x, and the antiderivative of this is going to be x squared. And you can always double check. If I take the derivative of this antiderivative, then we should get our original function. The derivative of this is going to give me 4. The derivative of this is going to give me 2x, and hence that's my original function. Question B is just a fancy way of saying, here, our gradient function is this. Find the original function. So we're going to do the antiderivative. So the antiderivative of 3x, power increases by 1, and then we multiply by the reciprocal of 2, which is going to give me 1/2. Okay. Consider the definite integral. Okay. Okay. So using this relationship here, we know that we've got the integral from 0 to x of 3 minus 2t dt. And my upper bound is f, is x, and my lower bound is 0. So the antiderivative of 3 minus 2t, so the antiderivative of 3 is 3t, and the antiderivative of negative 2t, okay, the power is going to increase by 1, so it's going to be 2, and then the reciprocal of this is 1/2, and 1/2 times 2 is going to be just t squared. Okay, and we go from 0 to x. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to plug in the x here in place of t, and end up with 3x minus, and then the x in place of here, and we get x squared. Okay, and if I plug in the 0, we're just going to get 0 and 0. Okay, draw the diagram and shade it. So we know that my function, 3 minus 2t, we start here at 3. My slope is negative 2, so I go over 1, I'm going to go down 2, and then I draw my line. Okay. And we end up with Okay, let's do the next one here. Okay, so this is going to give us the area underneath curves or lines, and it's going to be much better than when we were doing the Riemann sum, because that was only an estimate. So take the derivative of this, hence find the antiderivative of this. So the derivative of this is going to be the power decreases by 1, and then this 3 gets multiplied by the third, which is just going to give me this. Okay. Okay. So the antiderivative of x squared is this. Okay. So if, let me just write that down. If f of x equals x squared, the antiderivative is going to give me x cubed, and then we have to have the 1/3 here, right? And if I take the derivative, this power decreases by 1, and 3 gets multiplied by the 1/3, we get this. Okay, so antiderivative gives me this, derivative gives me this. Okay, so use the fundamental theorem of calculus to find the area under the curve of this from 0 to 1. My function is x squared. Don't forget the dx. So you have to write the dx. Okay, so we're going to have our antiderivative, and our upper bound is 1, and then minus, and then our antiderivative, and our lower bound is 0. Okay, so we're going to use our antiderivative, and our antiderivative is 1/3 x cubed. So I'm going to end up with 1/3 times, I'm going to plug in 1 in for x, so 1 cubed minus 1/3, and I'm going to plug in 0. Well, okay, you know that 0 cubed is 0, right? That's going to go away. And we end up with 1/3 times 1 cubed, which gives us an area of 1/3. Okay, so this area here under the curve is 1/3. Okay, if you watch the Professor Dave Explains video for this section, you'll also see he does the same problem. So this is just for reference of different derivative properties. Okay. You can hit pause and look at this, or you'll see it in your handout. So here's the notation that I was talking to you about in a minute that we'll continue to use as we go through this. So what they do is they put a long bar here, and then they put the upper bound and the lower bound right there of our derivative. And all calculus books do this, and you'll see this in the Professor Dave Explains video. So I'm going to put my long bar here, and our upper bound is 2, and my lower bound is 1. Okay, so now I'm going to take the antiderivative of x cubed. So we know that the power increases by 1, so it becomes 4. And then I have to have the reciprocal of this power, so the reciprocal of 4 is going to be 1/4 minus, and then this x becomes x squared. And we have a 4 already, and we have to have the reciprocal of this, so it's going to be 1/2. That's hard to read. Okay, and then instead of 5, we're going to have 5x. Okay, 4 times 1/2, that's just going to give me 2. So we have 1/4 x to the 4 minus 2x squared plus 5x. Okay, so now I'm going to plug in 2, and I'm going to place I'm going to place 2 in here. Because remember, we're doing f of 2 minus f of 1. So I'm going to put 2 in place of this. So then we're going to have 1/4 2 to the 4th power minus 2 times 2 squared plus 5 times 2. Okay? And then minus, and now we're going to do the same thing, except We're going to plug in 1 in place of x. So then we're going to have 1/4 1 to the 4th power minus 2 times 1 squared plus 5 times 1. Okay, you might want to hit pause to think about this. And okay, so then we simplifies to 4 minus 8 plus 10 minus 1/4 plus 2 minus 5, and then that simplifies to 2.75. okay. Let's do another example here. Okay, so the antiderivative of 2x. Okay, before I do the antiderivative, I'm going to rewrite this fraction here with a negative exponent. 2x plus 3 times x to the negative 2 power dx. Don't forget the dx. Okay, so the antiderivative of 2x is going to give me x squared. And we know that we've already got this 2 here. And we have to do the reciprocal of this power. So, and then we've got the power increases by 1. So instead of negative 2, it's going to be negative 1. And we're going to multiply negative 1 times the 3, so it's going to be minus 3. And this goes from 1 to 4. And you can always check. Okay, so let's rewrite this. This becomes x squared minus 3x to the negative 1, and from 4 to 1. Okay, let's double check. Did I do the antiderivative correct? If I did the derivative of x squared, I end up with 2x. Good. If I do the derivative of this, the negative 1 multiplies by the negative 3, I get positive 3, and this decreases by 1, I get negative 2. Check. So always check to see, did I do the antiderivative correctly? So the derivative of this gives me that. The derivative of this gives me that. Check. I did the antiderivative correctly. Now I'm going to plug in 4, in for x. So I'm going to plug in 4, in for x, and then I'm going to get 4 squared minus 3 over 4. Okay, now I'm going to plug in 1 in place of x. And then I'm going to get 1 squared minus 3 over 1. Right? And so now let's simplify that. I get 16 minus 3 fourths minus 1 minus 3. Okay, I have to do distributive property with a negative sign. I get 16 minus 3 fourths minus 1 plus 3. And my answer simplifies to 17.25. Okay, so these next two I'm going to set up. Okay, so the antiderivative of x cubed is power increases by 1, and we have the 1/4 here. I'm going to plug in 2 in place here, so I end up with 2 over 4. Oops. My mistake. End up with 1/4 times 2 to the 4th power minus 1/4 times 1 to the 4th power. Well, 2 to the 4th power is 16, and 16 divided by 4 equals 4. 1 to the 4th power is 1, so we've got minus 1/4. And so that's going to give me 3.75. Okay, now if I take the antiderivative of this, if I use my properties from here, it's the same thing. We can pretend that my value here is negative 1. We can factor that out. This is going to give me the same thing, except it's going to be negative. This antiderivative is going to give me negative 3.75. Okay, I'm going to put up my worked out answers here so you can check your work. You might want to hit pause. Okay, now I'm going to put the last page up here so you can check your work. Okay, I'm going to move it up so you can check your work. And G, H, and H, and I are a little bit tricky, and most likely won't have anything quite that tricky on the test. Let me know if you have any questions, and I hope this was helpful.